Hey guys, Sean Wanna coming back in with another battle replay here on Total War Rome 2. Welcome back to the Land of Sieges. We got a bit of a long one, so guys, sit down, get comfortable, get a drink, get something to eat. Almost an hour long battle, so it's going to be a good one. We are here on the settlement of Tarsus. Again, welcome back to the Land of Sieges. We do have a 3v3 siege. Let's take a look at the attacking forces first. We'll start off on this side with Rome being commanded by King Me Predator. He has brought 9 units of the Legionnaire Cohort, 4 Vigiles, 1 Praetorian Guard. His general is the Legatus. He also has 3 Syrian Archers and 1 unit of the Praetorian Cavalry. Moving over to his first ally, we do have Artaverni here being commanded by Multiplayer. Multiplayer is actually a member of the Hungry Wolves Discord. Actually, a lot of the guys. I don't know if this entire battle is Hungry Wolves Discord guys, but I know a decent amount of them are. At least 4 of them are. That I can tell you 100% by their names. They are definitely on the Hungry Wolves Discord. And what is this? We got some Pontus Citizen Cavalry coming out. I don't know how well that's... Oh, wait. What? Did he just... No, they're getting javied. Okay, I was going to say, did he just walk right past them without getting taken any damage? We do have some of the Levy Freeman. But Arverni here being commanded by Multiplayer. He has brought 7 Chosen Swordsmen, 5 Celtic Warriors, 2 Levy Freemen, 2 Oathsworn, one of those being his general. I'm assuming his archers are around somewhere, but... Oh, God. Rome. Come on, Rome. Beep, beep. Come on. No. Oh, God. Well, there goes some Syrian archers. Syrian archers just got charged, and that unit came a long way. The general's just sitting there. I don't know where the Praetorian cavalry went. He moved all the way up by the wall. He's got a unit of Praetorian guard just sitting here. They're eventually going to be out of javelins, but they are killing these citizen cavalry, so I don't know. They haven't gotten a whole lot of kills. Oh, yeah, a lot more dead there. They might actually start wavering them. That definitely could be helpful. Final attacking army on the battlefield we do have here is Carthage. Carthage is being commanded by Leviat Master. He has brought 2 units of Italian swordsmen, 2 Iberian swordsmen, 2 Gallic warriors, 1 Scutari. We also have some Samnite warriors here, 2 units of the Celtic Light Horse. Not seeing his archers. We have some late Libyan hoplites there, some more Scutari. So I don't think he's brought his entire army out yet. He's probably still got some more just kind of hanging out there in that little patch of woods there. Getting in onto the defenders, we will start off with Pontus, who appears to be the front line or first army on defense. We have Pontus being commanded by Olidog 2010. He has brought 6 units of Pontic Swords, one of those being his general, 4 Thoreo Spears, 2 Hoplites, 1 Bronze Shield Pikeman, 1 Regular Pikeman, 1 Hillman. He had 2 Citizen Cavalry. One of them is already gone. I think he had 2 Citizen... Oh, no, he only had 1 Citizen Cavalry. His Citizen Cavalry was here. It is already gone. It does seem that it is gone. And he also had brought with him... I just lost where he... There he is. 4 Eastern Archers. So that will round out the Pontus Force. Then we have Athens... Oh, sorry, Syracuse. Ooh, man. Syracuse here being commanded by the Pizza Maker. He has brought 5 Thorax Swordsmen, 3 Thoreo Spears, 3 Samnite Warriors. His general is a unit of the Thorax Hoplites, 2 Balearic Slingers, 1 Regular Slinger, 1 Archer, and a Citizen Cavalry for him. And then finally, we have Epirus being commanded by Armored Scarab, who's one of the 5 Hungry Wolves. So definitely good to see him in here. He has brought 4 Illyrian Levies, 3 Samnite Warriors, 3 Italian Swordsmen, 2 of the Mausolean Dogs, which are piling up over on this side by the Syracuse Cavalry. He also has 2 Hellenic Royal Guard. His general is a Royal Peltast, and he has brought 4 Archers. So there we go. Army comps out of the way, finally. Sorry if it took a little bit of time there. But Rome is now plowing their way in. Going to get into this Hillman unit, and that's just not going to live very long. That Hillman unit is not going to survive, as we pretty much all can tell, and we're all well aware of it. They did get some javelin volleys off, though, so that's something. Yeah, Hillman not looking good. Getting close to 100 men. What do we have here? Vigiles up on the walls, taking on some of the mercenary Italian swordsmen. The rest of the Roman... Where did they go? Wait a second. Where'd the rest of the art? Did he hide in the woods? Maybe he went into the woods. It's quite possible he went over into the woods there. A lot of walls coming down. Carthage necking down just another section of wall here. Actually, a double section. That is definitely going to be a nice breach for them to be able to use. Arverni inside the front gate taking on some of the hoplites here, and they are actually the hoplites not in hoplite formation. Still winning decisively, though. I wonder if the Celtic Warriors didn't get javelin volleys off before they charged in. Looks like maybe they got one javelin volley in there. Probably should have held them back and waited for a second volley, but this could be something. This could be right here. Arverni needs to go, though. If he gets through there, he could... I mean, does he have any cavalry? No, Arverni does not have any cavalry. Carthage does, though. And this could be an opportunity for Carthage to be able to get in, maybe at least scare them back, if not maybe kill some of these Eastern Archers. But actually, the Archers are now starting... The Eastern Archers are starting to get shot here by the Golic Hunters. Great shots, yet peeling this number down. They're wavering already with 97 left in the unit, and they're wavering. They're not really even firing, though. Like, some of them are kind of shooting. So that, unfortunately, looks like that's going to be... That's going to be a unit of Eastern Archers removed from the battlefield here very soon. Unless, nope, they're still firing. Yeah, I mean, take the opportunity. Burn them down if you can. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Just more guys getting shot in the head, in the back. Not looking good. Over here, we have another unit of the regular hoplites holding Rome back. And they actually... That doesn't really look very comfortable. They're kind of just being shoved around wherever Rome wants to shove them around. Oh, no, Rome's peeling off. He's going to send this unit in. Got some Thurio Spears right there. And they are they going to get some Javelin Volleys off? Yeah, no. No Javelin Volleys for that Thurio Spear unit. Oh, that is rough. That's like half the power of Thurio Spears just to throw those Javelins. But they got caught up in melee there. That is rough. But speaking of rough, what's going on over here? Legionnaire cohort, 146 kills, getting burnt. Oh, levies are just littering these Roman bodies with sharp, sharp, sharp death sticks. Oh, God. They're still alive, though. They're not giving up. Oh, I think they're going to give up soon here now, though. So far, Emperor's doing a fantastic job holding back on that wall. Still don't know where the general and those archers went. They're not showing themselves yet. Gate is on fire, or getting to be on fire. Okay, Carthage is feeling the need to burn the gate down, even though they pretty much, they own the front quarter. They could be taking this gate, or at least neutralizing. It is neutralized. They need to finish this unit off. Rome's got to get a unit over there. There you go. Yep. Hit these hoplites, and that hoplite unit will, there they go, starting to waver. Nice little javelin volley into the back of them. That should wipe them up. 56 of them left. Yeah, they're going to be gone. There they go. Routed away. So now the attackers will have control of the gate, and I'm going to suggest, yes, good, Carthage, you stopped burning the gate. Good. Because if they didn't stop burning the gate, it would have obviously burnt down. And the defenders, if need be, they could use the gate, along with, obviously, with the breach points. But they could use the gate to come back inside if they wanted to. They would lose some men from the oil, but the gate would be open and they'd be able to just come right through. What was this? Iberian swordsman. Ooh, no, that, see, that's not good either. Is this more Iberian? No, that's Golic Warriors at least. What is this? Golic Warriors getting smoked by a unit of Thorax swordsman. Yeah, they did. Holy crap, they got smoked. Wow, they got annihilated. Another unit on a tower here. We have some Iberian swordsmen just hanging out, sitting there waiting, looking for maybe an opportunity. But here we go. Some of the heavier hitters for Carthage now making their way in. Two Samnite warriors coming in. He's definitely got more. Oh, there it is. There it is. African pikeman is general. Three Cretan archers. Is this all three Cretan archers? Yeah, and a Balearic slinger coming in. Oh, God. Noble fighters. Ooh. Those guys are rough. And another unit of pikes. He's got two units of the African pikemen. Oh, no. That's dangerous. That can be very, very dangerous. Along with Arverni. I mean, Arverni still has all of his heavy hitters. He's just standing up one unit of his chosen swordsmen up there. His archers are inside the settlement, though, but they're kind of defended. They are kind of defended. Okay, I'll give him that. Praetorian cavalry inside the settlement. Really nothing for them. Nowhere for them to really go. Not just yet, but they're waiting. They'll find an opportunity. They're going to find something. I bet that Roman cavalry finds something for him to do. caused some sort of damage somewhere. But all right, let's get into some more of the fighting. Pretty much why you guys are here is to see some of this bloodshed. So let's zoom in on some of it. Some more thorough spears. Yes, we do. Hopefully they can get some javelins off. I'd fire into the Italians or the Celtics, something. Just start shooting into something. Or, hey, if you got the arm for it, toss at these Gallic Hunters. Start trying to burn them down, Thoreos. You should be able to hoof them that far. Why are they? Oh, they already have 25 kills. Oh. Another Thoreos spear right here, though. He's tossing into something. Throwing into some Celtic warriors. Might be clipping a little bit of these Legionnaire cohort. That's possible. Pontus is starting to get pushed back just a little bit on this side. The Roman war machine is definitely firing on a couple of cylinders. Not all cylinders yet. Oh, wait. Here comes the rest of the cylinders. Here comes the rest of the cylinders. Syrian archers coming out. Victoria Guard making his way back out again. Firing up onto the wall. Trying to hit these Illyrian levies. I wouldn't be using archer ammo on levies, personally. This unit of Legionnaire cohort should be able to destroy this unit. Another unit of Legionnaire cohort making up their... They're making their way up here. But look at the amount of red that's over here. My God. Rome has lost a lot of men over here. A lot of men. Holy wow. That is a lot of dead Romans right there. Amazing. Amazing amount of dead Romans right there. Here comes the light cavalry, though. What are they going to do? Carthage light horse. They have 6 kills. Looks like maybe they're trying to find an opportunity to worm their way in, get involved into something. It looks like maybe he came his way in through here. Are there any dead horses over here? Yeah, there's two. There's two dead horses right there. Okay, so some of them have died. Yeah, that unit lost one. This unit's lost 11. Oh my God, what did they try and do? 13 kills. Maybe they just tried to get a rear charge onto something. Starting to waver a unit of archers here, though. Another unit. Is that another unit of Eastern archers that are wavering? Or is that the same unit from before? They have... Nope, I think that's a different unit. I think that is a different unit. I think, yeah, Pontus already has one unit gone. Just look at this, though. That's actually really scary. 4 Gallic Hunters and 3 Cretan Archers. That's terrifying. In all seriousness, that's pretty terrifying. Is that a Balearic? Oh, the Balearic is in the center here too? Oh, man. Yeah, that's pretty scary. Because the defenders, I don't... Yeah, they have 2 Balearic Slingers there. Pontus has just Eastern Archers. Empress has regular Archers. Right, just all regular archers? Yeah, he's got all just regular archers there. So I would say the attackers definitely have the advantage in the archer department. A little bit in the melee department as well. A little bit in the infantry department. Little bit. And that's just because of some of Carthage. Obviously, my one of my loves are Verni here, having their chosen swords and their Oathsworn. Definitely, to me, gives them a pretty sizable advantage in the infantry game. But... sometimes it's not always about what you bring. Sometimes it's really about the skill of the player. So we'll have to see how the defenders deal with such, to me, solid odds. Not overwhelming odds, but pretty solid odds. Now we got some Thorax swords. We're moving their way forward. Arverni looks like he's going to pull this unit away. I would too. Just get him out of there. There's no point in keeping him over there. I mean, they were about to get charged. They were about to get hammered. So good move, Arverni, pulling them away. Can they still reach? No, they're not in range. They're not in range. Okay. So Rome over here looks like he's kind of stalling out, at least for the streets. Up on the wall here, though. Getting shot in the back. Well, that is definitely one way to deal with some Legionnaire cohort. Just shoot him straight in the back. Look at the amount of guys that just dropped. I'm going to sit here for a second. Hopefully they get another volley in here.
want to watch the amount of Romans that just fall.
Yeah, that was a decent amount. I didn't even have a chance to count to see how many that was, but one of the Legionnaire cohorts is already wavering. Already wavering. Not been up there for very long. Yeah, but once they start getting hit again, dropping more, but Syrians here now. Okay. Actually, look at that. The Gallic Hunters moved over, giving Rome a hand against these Epirus Archers. Ooh, ow, ouch, 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 ouch. Epirus Archers here starting to drop, but I mean, they're probably almost out of ammo. 189, 182. I don't blame Epirus at all for leaving them there. What's going on over here? We got some more archers that have moved up over there. These guys got to be almost out. They are out. This unit's out. This unit's probably got one volley left. 205 kills, though. Solid. Very, very solid. Some of them putting their bows on their backs. Nope, they just pulled them back out again. But they're firing at the one that's out of ammo. Now this one's out of ammo too. So very well done by Epirus. He took all the time that he was given to shoot him out, shoot him all down. These Roman 2 units here have taken a lot of losses. A lot of losses. Back over here in the center though, Pontus is trying desperately. Looks like he's trying desperately. Oh wait, no. We have some of the Syracuse Thurio Spears have moved over here as well. But this isn't even the big scary units yet from the attackers. I mean, these are just still Celtic warriors. We have a unit of Scutari. Scutari is pretty solid. Definitely a solid infantry unit. But I'm not saying anything bad about Celtic warriors because I've seen Celtic warriors get 200, 300, 400 kills as well. So, I mean, but this isn't even the big boys yet for the attackers. Spears there for Syracuse has pulled back. Pontus Swordsman getting shot in the back. What's going on over here? Are these guys moving yet? No. The dogs and this citizen cavalry are just kind of hanging out over here. Just waiting for an opportunity. I don't know what opportunity they're waiting for, but I guarantee it's going to be something good. I can't guarantee it. I'm going to say it's probably going to be something good. Like this. Again, Epirus Archers shooting Romans in the back and just dropping them where they stand. Where are the Syrian archers? Oh, here they come. I think they're getting too close. What are they firing at? Oh yeah, they're firing up over here. They're firing into this one unit here of archers, already up to 71 kills. This unit here with 79, now 81 82, and the Epirus archers are going to pull away. Probably still have a decent amount of ammunition left. Judging by the first two units that he had that dropped over, you know, both of them over 200 kills, he's probably got a decent of ammunition left because he was just shooting them all in the back. So, Gallic Hunters here, 100 and shooting here with 84. Another unit back there with 86. Does all of his Gallic Hunters, did he lose a unit? Oh, it looks like maybe he lost a unit or they're hiding because Gallic Hunters do that. They hide. Arverni is just waiting. This is going to be really bad. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 units of Chosen Swords, 2 Oathsworn. That is going to be dangerous. Once this is going to break, it's already starting to shatter. It's already starting to drop. Celtic Warriors now going to get... Ooh, wow. Barely caught. Should have thinned them up just a little bit more. That's exactly what I would do with this unit. I'd pull them back, thin them up, and then try and bring them through again. Or this unit. Actually, this unit... They might be able to fit through there. They might be able to fit through that gap right there. But Arverni was definitely on the right track there, trying to get some units through the gaps. Here comes Cretan Archers for Carthage. 2 units moving their way forward, 75, 18. This unit here with 63, that's the Balearics. Other unit of Cretans back here with 27. So Carthage definitely still has a decent amount of ammunition left with some of his units. Here we go. Another smaller unit going to come over. Probably going to try and hold. They should try and hold this Pontic Swordsman back. But nope, looks like they're just going to connect there. Okay. Some more Celtic Warriors making their way up. Going to hit that gap, I should say. Here comes some big boys. Sam Knight Warriors for Carthage going to make their way forward. Are they just going to charge? They're just going to go right into... Okay. They're just going to go right into the combat. I was thinking that they were going to come around as well and try and hit into these Pontic Swordsmen and give, you know, give Arverni a little bit of a hand there. But all right, Carthage is actually pressing over here. Some Italian Swordsmen into Thorax. Behind them, we have the Sam Knight Warriors just starting to throw their javelins. This unit is still on this tower. This tower's going to burn, dude. This is not... Yeah, you don't want to leave them on there for very much longer. Hopefully he's paying attention to this. That's all I'm going to say. Hopefully he's paying attention over here because it's Iberian swordsmen. They have their uses. They have javelins. They have the precursor javelins. You can tell them where to throw them. All that stuff. I'm pretty sure they can. I'm pretty sure that's Iberian swordsmen. I'm still learning other factions other than barbarian factions. Chosens have now made their way in. Oathsworn up by the gates. Actually, one of the Chosens is making their way in. The Oathsworn general is coming in. The other Oathsworn unit is making his way in, I should say. So you can hear that music intensifying just a little bit. Battle's going to be getting a little bit more crazy. Praetorian cavalry charging in. Going to help this unit of Legionnaire Cohort out with this mercenary Sam Knight unit. But we do have another unit of Sam Knights coming over here. That cavalry better get out of here. Run away. Pontic cavalry, run away. That's actually a really good target right there. Just smash into that unit of swordsmen. Charge them. Very, very heavy cavalry. Just smash right through this tiny unit of Italian swordsmen. You'll help take this gate. Please don't just stand there. And you're going... Oh, well, you had to come this way, yeah. Sam Knights came around the corner. We're almost getting into that Gallic Hunter unit. Ooh, actually, another unit of Sam Knights coming. Ooh, man. I think this Praetorian Cavalry, yeah, he's starting to lose some men down. 13, 14, 15 men now. Oof. Those Italians charged in onto the back of them. So that's going to be some more of the Praetorian Cavalry losing. Let's see. I mean, still so far, let's take a look at the topographical map here. Still looking pretty solid. I would say the defenders are doing a pretty good job. They've fallen back a little bit. They've kind of given up. They haven't really given up. They've been beaten here, but they're still holding rather effectively in this area, holding this gate still. So they're doing a very solid job, I would say, so far. The defenders doing a really good job holding, but this center here does not look like it's got a lot of strength left in it. But here we go. Syracuse sending up some more of his Sam Knights. We have a unit of Pontic Swordsmen that wavered and broke. They have now returned to the battlefield. Some more of the Thorax Swordsmen making their way around over here. Yes, he did. He brought that unit of Iberian Swordsmen down off of the tower. As you can see, it is engulfed in flames. 85% damage. So that will be crumbling here in just a few moments. Still, the Mausolean Dogs and the Citizen Cavalry just hanging out. Oh, wait. Citizen Cavalry starting to move. I wonder where he's thinking of going. We actually have a unit of slingers up on the wall over here for Syracuse. I wonder what is his plan there. I mean, he could bring the slingers down here and just start firing down. That is definitely a viable option. But I'm kind of really interested to see what he's going to do with the Citizen Cavalry. They've come outside of the settlement now. I wonder what they're going to do. What is this? Pontic Swordsmen that have routed. 110 kills, 14 of them left. Yeah, you kind of got your money worth out of them, I would say. Back in the center, though. Ooh, some Celtic Warriors starting to waver there, but the Chosens have now moved up with the Sam Knight Warriors. So the Chosens of Arverni and the Sam Knights here for Carthage moving their way inside deeper into the settlement. Pontus and Syracuse actually getting a big push here from the defense. The defenders kind of pushing kind of hard right there. Thorax Swordsman. Sam Knights, Pontic Swordsman actually getting through. If he could wrap around, I would charge into the back of the... Oh, no, never mind. He's caught. That Pontic Swordsman unit just got mauled. Oh, God. Noble fighters finishing that off. No problem. Chosen Swordsman going to come over and get their blades wet as well. Still pressing forward, though. Chosen Swordsman here with the Sam Knights of Carthage. Back over here, Rome. Rome really doesn't have a lot of infantry left. Yeah, he's pretty much burned out. Unless he retreated some back to the woods. But Rome is pretty much tapped out infantry-wise. He's got his Praetorian Guard there. Still full unit of Praetorian Guard. That could definitely come in handy. Legionnaire cohort that came back from routing. He still got the Praetorian Cavalry, his general, and his three units of archers, 76, 30, and 97. So those Syrians should still have a little bit of ammo left to their name. Hopefully, they'll have some more ammunition left over. But this center is starting to look a little, again, starting to look like the defenders might actually have to start vacating this center area. Noble fighters now charging in onto the Samnites, going to help that Scutari unit out. Back around over here, you can see that Arverni is neutralized the towers. He's neutralized the gate. Okay, that's good. This unit should probably charge in. This unit's actually not even really fighting. So this chosen swordsman unit needs to turn. There you go. Celtic warriors, chosen swordsman taking on a Samnite. Should be a victory for Arverni there. Just on the man count alone, it should be a victory. Samnites are a very tough unit, but should still... Oh, no, Pontus! Pikemen up here, they're getting wrecked. Oh, that's not good. Yeah, I mean, he's going to move them forward, but they're just going to keep... Yeah, more shots and more shots and more shots and more shots, and they're going to be gone. Yeah, not a good decision. Not a good decision. Not trying to sound like, mean or whatever. Just the want and the desire was there to try and help hold this line, but you got to look surroundings. You got to try and look surroundings. There was so many archers in the relative close area that just blasted that unit of pikes out of the water. Very rough to see there. You never really want to see pikes just get dismissed like that. Here we go. The light cavalry now making their way forward. Looks like Syracuse is actually pulling back. That Thorax Swordsman unit's going to get cut off. I don't think this Samnite's going to get out of here, but he's probably leaving the Samnites to try and hold for as long as they can. Here comes that light horse making their way over. They're going to try. Do not charge that Thorax. Do not charge that Thorax. Yeah, pull him back out. I mean, they were about to get caught. I mean, he could have tried to run them this way and caught this unit of slingers out, but that's a Pontic Swordsman general right there. There's more infantry right here that could have tried to come around this way. This unit of Thoreo Spears coming back, they could have peeled. Oh, no, they got caught anyway. The Thorax Hoplites caught out a unit of the Celtic. Yeah, the Light Horse. Run them away. Get them away from that general. Got some chosen swordsmen making their way over here. That's something. Thorax swordsman. That was the unit that got caught out. Here come. Nope. The Celtic Light Horse coming in again. Another charge. Wow. That was actually a pretty solid charge. Knocked over a lot of guys. Didn't really kill very many. He only killed one. But here comes those chosens now getting in. And this is the general. This is the Syracusian general here. So we're going to definitely have to keep an eye on that. The Syracuse general is now kind of getting caught out. He's kind of being... Nope, he's pulling back. He's going to pull back. Is this chosen sword going to continue following him, though? Will he follow that bait? I mean, it's not really a bait. There's nothing else really right there. Thorax, you only lost 19. Not terrible. Not the end of the world. He lost 20 men. He killed 20 men, so he's kind of even. He's pretty much even. Chosen Swords now coming over. They're going to finish off this unit of Samnites. So, yeah, the front part of this settlement has now been taken over by the attackers. Took them roughly about a half an hour to do it, which is fine because they still have another, according to this replay, there's still another 28 minutes to go. And let's take a quick stock of the defenders. Epirus still has two units of his archers, though they have used some of their ammo, one unit with 93, one with 94. Epirus also still has some mercenary Samnites there. Sam Knight running away. Royal Peltas General. He still has his two units of pikes, his two units of Hellenic Royal Guard. And I think, does he still have those dogs? Yes, he still has the dogs over here. Probably waiting for a well-timed use for them. Because, I mean, they can do damage. Mostly good against archers, though. Maybe some light infantry, but mostly good against archers. And I think they're good against light cavalry. They can be good against all cavalry, but like the Praetorian cavalry here, very armored. Very armored, 70 armor. Take him a little while to get through there. Let's see what else we have. We have Syracuse here with his general, some more Thorax swordsmen, Samnite warriors. In the town center, he's got two of his Balearic slingers. And then Pontus. Yeah, Pontus is pretty much gone. Let's see what Pontus has. Maybe back at the town center. He's got an Eastern Archer retreating, Pontic Swordsman, and a Bronze Shield Pikeman. Pretty sure that's all Pontus has left. Yeah, that is going to be all that Pontus has left. So, I mean, it's still a pretty close battle. Here comes the general. Carthaginian Noble Cav General's charging around. Can it catch these the Citizen Cavalry out? I mean, they went after a pretty easy target. They went after the Celtic Light Horse, probably just trying to get rid of them. That's probably why they went over there. Yeah, so you could see the Citizen Cavalry trying to get through, but I don't think many of them are going to get away. Well, no, there's still over 50 of them with the unit. Let's see. Can they get out? Can they get away with more than 50 men? No. No. As soon as it hit 50, I knew they weren't going to. But 46 of them, still over half the unit is alive. And here we go. Marcellian dogs unleashed. Oh, going to the... Yeah, doggies. Get those horses. And are the handler? Yep, the handler's going in as well. So there you go. Yep, like light horse is getting eaten. They're getting chewed up. Literally chewed up. Dogs have lost about 22 of them, but they are still doing damage. They've got 13 kills so far. They're taking out a unit of light horse. Here comes the other unit of light horse, though. Yeah, this might be the end of the pups. Might be the... Nope, they're finishing off that unit. But here they come. Light horse going to charge in. Let's see if we can zoom in, see any of the dogs yet. The dogs are still there. Still doing what they can. Some of them are beaten. Some of them are bloodied. But they are still biting at these horses. Trying to rip these riders down. Here comes that Citizen Cavalry, actually. Wow. Citizen Cavalry coming around, helping finish off that other unit of the light horse. But, oh, no. The Noble Cav General for Carthage has now made his way over. Yeah, Marcellian Gog. Yeah, they're going to be gone. Citizen Cavalry might not be a bad idea. Just run away. Try and get out of there. Maybe be used for a different part. But all right, over halfway through this battle replay, guys. And I would say we've had a lot of death. We've had a lot of death to get to this point. I mean, Rome, again, looking over here, the amount of Roman soldiers that have lost their lives is just crazy. Crazy the amount of Romans that have died up here. I mean, you could see some Empress guys, but there is a lot of Roman soldiers over here dead. Which is definitely unfortunate because another Roman army has not done well. Another Roman army, I'm not trying to, I'm just stating truth. Another Roman army has not done well in a battle replay that I am covering. So, hopefully, at some point, we will get a Roman army that does, like, really, really, really well. I know that Rome is very powerful. I'm not a huge fan of Rome, but I know that Rome is a very powerful faction. I know they can cause massive amounts of damage. So we are about halfway through the battle replay. If you guys are enjoying it, please make sure to hit that like button, drop a comment down below. Subscribe to the channel if you are new to seeing my content. Feel free, hit that subscribe button. That will definitely help me out with the YouTube algorithm, and obviously also it'll give me more subscribers, and you know, that's a pretty cool thing. Getting close to 6,200 subscribers. The channel is definitely growing pretty steadily at this moment. I'm very, very happy with the amount of growth and the amount of new subscribers and watch time and views and everything like that. The people showing up for live streams. I mean, while units are moving around, I'm going to talk a little bit here. So last night I streamed Total War Three Kingdoms, and I was not really... Actually, wait, what do we got here? Levy Freeman just coming over. I think they were just trying to slow down. Maybe they're just trying to cause some problems. Maybe they're just trying to cause some problems for the Royal Peltast. Didn't last very long there. But yeah, so I streamed Total War Three Kingdoms last night on my channel, and not a whole ton of people showed up, but people showed up, and I was kind of shocked. And I said it at the end of the stream. I was a little shocked. I think at one point I got up to like 30 people or something like that. Going from what I've always heard, not a lot of people like Three Kingdoms. They all thought that it was garbage, it was trash, it was this, it was that. If you guys aren't huge fans of Three Kingdoms, which you're perfectly entitled to do and say, you know, think what you want to think, I'm just saying, watch the first actual battle. If you would indulge me, watch the first actual battle that took place, the 4v4 siege that we had. and it was pretty badass. I don't normally curse in replays, but it was pretty badass. It was a solid battle. But yeah. So, all right, we got some Chosen Swordsman eating some javelins from Sam Knights. So combat is now continuing. All right, get off that guy's shoulders. You see that guy just levitate out of nowhere? That was weird. And then the night before that, I also streamed Rise of Mordor, which again, the first time I ever streamed Rise of Mordor. It is the first time I ever streamed Total War Three Kingdoms. And you know, I'm just throwing out a big thank you to all the guys that showed up, all the guys and girls, men and women, whoever. I don't know who all you guys are, you know, but very appreciative for all of the guys and people, men and women, or whoever, the people who have shown up to my streams, those two streams in particular, because it was just kind of like a, hey, let's give it a shot, see what happens. And it seems like it kind of got received pleasantly. It was a pleasant receival, I would say. Receival? That's not a word. I was surprised. I'll say it that way. I was surprised with the amount of people that showed up. It was definitely cool to see the amount of people that showed up for Total War. You know, like I said, a lot of people don't like Three Kingdoms. So, but it was cool to see you guys show up. So I just wanted to say, long-windedly, apparently, very, very long-windedly, I just wanted to extend and say my thanks for you guys to come and hang out. It was definitely very cool. And, yeah, it was definitely really cool. And thank you very much. So, but all right, let's get back into this. Arverni is starting to shuttle his armies around. Rome still, yeah, he's still kind of just moving around, but he doesn't have a lot. Carthage does look like he's going to be the one that comes around this way. Carthage is going to be the one that comes this way. He might maybe send a unit this way to help Arverni out. But look at the defense right here. Solid. Very, very nice setup here for the defense. We got some Sam Knights. Is this both Sam Knights? No, it's a Thorax and a Sam Knight. I like that box off formation right there. They're doing a great job. Epirus over here doing a good job. He's got his Hellenic Royal Guard right there. Taking a little bit of damage. Lost two men so far. Where are those hunters? Gallic hunters, Syrian archers definitely should be over here trying to shoot at this Hellenic Royal Guard. Try and get that out of there. What is moving around? The Praetorian Cav is going to make their way over here. Going to test this road. We do have a unit. The Pontic Swordsman General is making his way over here. Getting into Shield Wall, which I don't know if I'd get into Shield Wall, because you won't be able to throw javelins. And they still do have javelins. Citizen Cavalry came outside. They've now been seen. So I think, are they coming over here to just... I would neutralize the gate. Just stay there and neutralize it. Cut that gate off from them being able to use it. Where is the nearest breach? Nearest breach is way back over here. So that Citizen Cavalry is going to have a long, long trek because the attackers have captured... They did capture all the gates? That gate really doesn't matter, and it does look like Carthage is in the process of capturing this gate as well. So it's going to definitely decrease the amount of activity that the defenders can have in getting their cavalry back inside. He's going to have to go back around over by that breach point. But all right, again, a lot of yapping done by Joe. I'm going to shut up, let you guys watch some more fighting. And some Levy Freeman. Oh, they were going to go forward. They noticed the pikes. Nope. All right, so we got a pretty long delay here. Pretty long delay. I wonder why does the Gallic Hunters not have any ammo left? Oh. No, one of the units does. Oh, no, they're firing. They are firing way back over here at the Balearic Slingers. I mean, that's definitely a valuable option. If I was Rome, though, I'd get these Syrians over here and start firing. You want to try and burn down one of these Royal Guards. They definitely want to get rid of a unit of pikes, because unless they have javelins left, which is possible. I mean, the Osworn General still has javelins. That Osworn doesn't. That one, yeah, he's got no kills. He should still have javelins. Probably not. So, I mean, some of his units still have javelins, but it looks like the majority of them do not. So, not a whole lot of other ways to get rid of pikes. This unit, let's see, do they have javelins left? Looks like they're just kind of like lining up in a very weird formation right now. I don't think they have javelins, though. unless it's taking an extra couple of seconds for them to figure out that they should be throwing their javelins right now. It does not look like they do, and Epirus is going to push forward. Run away! Run away. Nope, he's going to stand firm. They are going to stand firm here. Levy Freeman there getting shot in the back. Oh, that is not nice. Balearic Slingers getting some great shots down into these Levy Freeman in the back. Just burning them down slowly. Yeah, get around the corner. Levy Freeman are going to pull back. Oh, I'm sorry, the Chosen Swords are going to pull back, but that Levy Freeman not looking good. Again, Syrian Archers. This would be one of your times to shine. Right now, all three of them, just get them up here. Have them get some shots. This Pike unit is probably going to eventually turn around to run back up the hill again. Or not. Are they coming down? What are they doing? Oh, they're being weird. They're being weird. But that right here, this is an opportunity to start shooting them. Rome, you got... Well, he's moving them now. Okay, he's bringing his archers around. He still has the Praetorian Guard near them to try and keep an eye on them. Make sure that they stay safe. Cretans making their way up. I don't know if they still have ammo. Well, that one does. They still have their bows out. So 166, this unit here, 79. This unit there with 139. So they definitely still have some ammunition left. And this unit is in shield wall. So it would probably be beneficial for Carthage to throw one of his units of archers up on the wall and have them fire down this way. But nope, never mind. Epirus and Balearics there. So Epirus has a unit of regular archers. Syracuse there with a unit of the mercenary Balearic Slingers making their way over here. Pikes, African pikemen making their way forward. Okay, I wonder where they're going. I wonder what they're thinking to do here. He's still trying. Looks like he's trying to keep them out of range of the archers and the slingers, but they don't know they're here. The attackers don't know that these two units are here. They can't see them. Obviously, you guys, for newer players or new, brand new players or whatever, you guys can see. Obviously, you can see the eyeballs over their head, over their banners, or you can simply just put your cursor over the banners and you'll see that same eyeball with the hidden right there. So the attackers do not know that those units are up on that top ridge there. Bronze Shield pikemen making their way over here. That's a solid unit of pikes right there. They are going to start getting shot, though. Back over on this side is Rome. They are. The Roman archers are firing at slingers. They're firing at the slingers, which I guess is okay. I would have one of the units firing at these pikes, though. Or actually, now... Pike, one of the archers could maybe move over here and start firing in onto the flank of that pike unit. That could be good. Mausoleum dogs have moved in, though. Just ended up noticing this. I don't think this one was as successful. No. This one was not as successful as the previous unit of Mausoleum dogs. But still, at the end of the day, they killed some more of the Praetorian cavalry. I'd like to think they killed some more of the Praetorian cavalry. Slingers for Syracuse, regular slingers, and Balearics making their way around over here. Let's see what kind of vantage point they would have. Let's get down to pretty much where their level would be. They could shoot this Oathsworn. That's pretty much clear as day right there. But as far as any sort of arcing shots or anything like that, the slingers can't really do that. I mean, they can have a little bit of an arc to their shot, but not like an archer. Definitely not like an archer could. Chosen Swords charging up again. Archers are pulling back. We have the Royal Peltast General. Looks like he might end up coming over here. Yeah, it looks like he's going to do exactly what Syracuse was doing on the other side. Box up over on that side. No, he's just going to stand side by side there. Oh, God. Celtic Warriors, what are you doing? 69 giggity. Just saw they had 69 kills. So got that in there. Nice. Very cool. Back around over on this side. A lot of archer fire coming. Epirus archers, 126 kills. Are they out of ammo? Yes, they are. Oh, no. Okay, well, that's not a good thing for the defenders. Bronze Shield pikemen are getting wrecked. Again, getting destroyed. Ooh, that is rough to watch. That is very, very rough to watch. Let's zoom in. Yeah, they're getting wrecked. How many are they up to? 64, and they're still just getting shot. They're going the wrong way. They need to pull back. They're going to keep getting shot.
Now he's going to try and pull him back. Too little, too late on that one. Yeah, they're going to get shot in the back as they're running. That's going to be the end. Bronzier pikemen on their way out. That's rough. That's an expensive unit of pikes right there. Very expensive unit. So unfortunately, Pontus has now been removed, minus his general and one unit of Eastern archers there. He did lose the other unit of his pikes, which just rough. Very, very rough. Speaking of pikes, let's get back over here, see how the Hellenic Guard is doing, the Hellenic Royal Guard. They're kind of getting picked away. Kind of getting picked down, down to 104. We've got the Roman archers still firing. Yeah, Syrian archers are still firing right into that one unit. Now, they need to remember there is a second unit. You can see them. They're right there. That is a second unit of Hellenic Royal Guard. You're definitely going to need to save some ammunition for that. They are definitely dropping this unit pretty quickly. Now they have their back showing. The Syrian archers firing in onto them. Just dropped another six right there. Not too bad. Dropping some more as they're making their way through the general. Now down to 70. They just lost in that small, in that short retreat right there. They lost 16 more guys. So not too bad. Arverni over here looked like he tried to press his luck a little bit. Here comes the Hellenic Royal Guard making their way out over here as well. Pontus is trying to hold, but I don't think that general is going to be a hold back against the Noble Fighters very long. And I don't know. I mean, there's still some right there. They got some Sam Knights right there. Thorax Hoplite General's there. I mean, if need be, maybe this Thorax Swordsman could pull back around and try to help hold this side. We'll have to see. That Pontic Swords General is not looking good, though. He is pretty much just getting wrecked. Carthage just pressing up. Yeah, bringing up a unit of African pikemen now just to help try and push their way through. Hey, Hellenic Royal Guard making their way over here. If we're going to have some pikes, we're going to have some pikes. Now, let's see. Hellenic Royal Guard, 46, 28, 90, 60. Melee defense, 38. The African pikemen are 38, 24, 70, 25. So the Hellenic Royal Guard is actually better. 28, 24, 90, 70. So yeah, the Hellenic Royal Guard is actually much better than the African pikemen. Much, much, much better. That African pikemen is still standing. Yeah, they are. They're still standing there. They're actually moving forward. Man, they're actually moving forward. That is a tough fight, and the African pikemen, I think they just... Did they break? Oh, yeah, they broke. They're done. Out of here. 49 kills. Hellenic Royal Guard, 99 kills. Still over half the unit left. Wow. That was a great showing right there. I think that was a great showing of difference between top-tier pikes and good pikes, but not top-tier pikes. I think that was a good showing right there. Ooh, Osworn. Osworn and Osworn General charged in. Now that we're going to pull back. They were fighting the Royal Peltast General. This unit of Hellenic Royal Guard on this side, though, not looking good. 107 kills, though. 107 kills, not too shabby. Is Rome out of ammo? Not sure. No, some of them have bows. Some of them still have their bows in their hands. This one does. Is it the 103 that still has ammo? I don't know. One of them has ammo, though. I saw them pull their bows back out. Yeah. You can see some of those Syrians right there. It It's a unit with 103, so they maybe have another shot or two. What about these guys? No. This one unit of the Syrians still have ammo. Archers are getting beaten up. Hellenic Royal Guard pressing in again. They've lost seven more men since the last time we looked over here. Empress is looking a little worse for wear. It's getting close. Balance of power is definitely in favor of the attackers. I just noticed that now, too. Balance of power is definitely in favor of the attackers. We have one unit of Hellenic Royal Guard holding over on this side. Sam Knights, Noble Fighters, Sam Knights, Scutari, Pikemen, Cretans, Balearics, 230, 162. I think these guys are all out of ammo. Ooh, that is rough. It's definitely rough. This is the sizable unit, though, on this side. 91 left in that unit. Hellenic Royal Guard on this side, not looking too good. Down to 21 men now. But again, the Balearic Slingers up on that wall. Syracuse Balearic Slingers getting some great shots down into those Oathsworn. Chasing back the Syrian archers there. I think he actually just chased the Oathsworn general back out and around that corner there, too. Praetorian Guard, I mean, might not be a bad idea to throw a Praetorian Guard in there. Let them start trying to do some damage. They have 35 kills, but they could do some damage. A little bit of an opportunity right here. Little bit of an opportunity. Try and get something through there. Get into the side of something. Are they coming up? No, that is a unit of the Chosen Swordsmen making their way forward, and Sam Knights are going to block that off. Yep. So, all right, pull them back. Pull them back. Finally, yeah, Rome, not finally, I don't mean to say finally. Rome is now finishing off this unit of Hellenic Royal Guard. The Pontus General, for some reason, just started. Wait, why? 47 men. Where are the rest of his men? Oh, they're up in melee. And the Pontus General just broke. Ouch. Royal Peltas General now moving up to hold that position, to assume that position that the Pontus General was just in. Oathsworn now charging in again. Loyalty and presence. Whoa, hold on a second. I gotta see what those are. Recharge rate. Your general reduces the cooling down times for nearby units' abilities by 60%. Ooh, that's pretty nice. And loyalty. Target friendly units to greatly improve their defensive capabilities. Make their morale unbreakable for extended period. Can only be used one defense and unbreakable. All right, so that's good. That's the Vercingetorix. I think that's the Vercingetorix ability. It's used once. Did it hit the whole army? The presence hit the whole army. I guess maybe the loyalty hits whatever units are nearby. I haven't used that ability very much. So, but I'm pretty sure that's the Vercingetorix ability. Royal Peltas on their way out. So the Empress General is slowly. Oh, no, never mind. Slowly. He just shattered. So there was only 29 of them left. But still, look at that. 335 kills. Wow, that's amazing. But this is not good. This part right here is not good for the defenders. 3 minutes and 50 seconds left, guys. And this is wide open now. Oathsworn getting into the Pontus Archers. Pontus Archers still trying to run. Hellenic Royal Guard over here now being moved up on by a unit of African Pikemen. We watched them best the first unit of African Pikemen that came over here. So let's see if they're going to have the same kind of luck. Though they definitely have a lot less men than they did the first time that they fought. Empress over here is trying to hold back some Syrian archers with his regular archers. What is still around? I don't see very much left here for the defenders. The Thorax Hoplite General is pulling his way back. Remember, this is the town center right here. So all the defenders really need to do is hold this staircase, and if they can hold that path, then they should be okay. We'll see. Balance of power is not seeming very much in favor of the defenders right now. We still have some Sam Knights up over there fighting. Sam Knights over there still fighting. They're actually doing pretty well. This Sam Knight unit is currently winning right now. He's fighting the Cavalry General, Sam Knights, beating a unit of Balearic Slingers and a unit of Scutari over there. The Syrian archers for Rome tried to make their way up the staircase. They have been cut off by the Thorax Hoplite General, but the second unit is making their way up the stairs. They're going to get into these Slingers. Are they going to stop them? What are they doing? Oh, no. Thorax Hoplites, no. You need to stay there. Look at this. Look at this Syrian archer unit. Looked like he was trying to just worm his way around to get up into that town center. That's hilarious. Here comes the Carthage general, though. Smash. Oathsworn general now making his way around. Under 2 minutes, guys. This is under 2 minutes left in this battle. This is close. Not really that close, though. I don't know. Thorax Hoplite's still around. Taking on the Chosen Swords and that unit of Oathsworn. Actually, General's pulling back. The Syracuse General is making his way back. He's going to try and get into that Carthage General there. The Oathsworn General has made his way around the corner, slicing into this Hellenic Royal Guard. Knocking them down. Almost 300 kills, though, for the Hellenic Royal Guard. They did a pretty solid job against those African pikemen. I definitely have to say that. They were under 100. I think they were at like 98 men. They're still at 54. African pikemen now here under half. They're at 44 men left. 59 seconds left in this battle replay. And here it goes. Thorax General is charging out. Looks like he's just going to go for the last bit that he can go for. Oh, here comes the Carthage General. Big charge. Big charge. Thorax Hoplite still holding, though. Town center is neutralized. It's not over. 30 seconds, guys. Can these defenders hold this? I know it wasn't the full hour-long replay, but actually, I'm going to keep that up so we can see the time. Another huge charge coming in there. Oh, the general. Nope, but the Samnites over here are still holding. The Samnites are still holding. Oh, my God. 14 seconds, 12 seconds. Oh, they're wavering. They are wavering. Will they hold? 6, 5, 4, 3, no. Wow, what a battle. That was solid. Like I said, I know it wasn't the full hour, but sometimes you just don't know who's going to break and what's going to happen there. But that was a great, great, great battle. Guys, thank you very much. Armored, thank you for sending this in. All six of you, though, all of you did great. Really, really well done. You did what you needed to do when you could do it. But all right, let's take a look. Epirus here. His general, 335 kills. Archers, 189, 216, 140, 139. I mean, God, from regular archers, that's solid right there. Hellenic Royal Guard, 309, 123. Look at the Illyrian levies, 169, 103. What? Levies. That's insane. Italian swordsman, 205. Sam Knights, 143, 143, 93. The dogs, yeah, not a whole lot. Pizza Maker here with Syracuse. His general, 102 kills. Citizen Cavalry, unfortunately, not a whole lot. Archers, 266. Slingers, 132, 141, 146. Great showing there. Sam Knights, 245, 102, 182. Thorax, 133, 182, 159, 207. Thoreos, 125, 112. And then we have Ollie Dog here. Ollie Dog, 2010. His general did what he could do, 37 kills. Archers, 187, 90. Pikemen just did not. Yeah, they got pretty much shredded. Let's see, Hillman not a lot. Pontic Swordsman, 110, 130, 127. One of his Thoreo Spears there with 81 kills. Then we get into Carthage here with Leavitt Meister, 2397. So almost 2,400 kills, not too bad. Carthage, General, 205. Slingers, 235. Archers, 162, 195, 103. Pikes, 124. Noble Fighters, 386. Italian Swords, 159. Sam Knights, 184. Scutari, 262. Very solid. Multiplayer with Arverni, 2,351 kills. Oathsworn General, 203. Archers, 143, 140, 114, 110. Not too shabby at all there. Celtic Warriors, one unit there, 175. Chosen Swords, 105, 159, 153, 134, 106. And his other unit of Oathsworn there, 286 kills. So not too bad with his two Oathsworn. Not bad with, 2,300 kills, 2,350, not bad. And then King Bee Predator,
His Roman forces here massing 2,167 kills. The Legatus General not really being very effective. Praetorian Cav, 123. Praetorian Guard, 129. Barely lost anybody. Syrians, great day. 232, 135, 152. Legionnaire Cohort here, 152, 263, 159, 212, 172, 158. And his Vigilante, yeah, not a whole lot there. But all right, guys, there you go. End of the battle replay. Fantastic replay. Hit that like button, drop a comment, share the content around, subscribe to the channel if you are new. Have a good rest of your day. Check out the links below. Bearded, Ellington, Gorm, Hungry Wolves Discord, Patreon's down, my Patreon's down there. If you want to, you can. If you don't, you want to, that's fine too. Have a good rest of your day, guys. Stay safe, and as always, until the next one.